In this video, we'll learn how to filter through a list of items using a select element. So what we have here is a list of items with all of our calls, and we have two select elements. We see that by default, they are called input select. So what we'll do first is we'll rename them filter by duration. Let's do that. When we modify the name here, it also modifies it here. And if we go to our list of components variables, it modifies it here as well. So now we have the filter by duration. This is important because we're going to need to tell this collection that it needs to be filtered through this variable. So it's easier if we have a different name. So filter by duration instead of input select, and we're not sure which one to pick. Okay, let's configure the options of our select element. We can call one, for example, more than 10 minutes. And this is the label. This is what will be displayed on our select, but the value we want it to filter on is 10. Do the same here with over 50 minutes and 50. And we can add an option here. Let's do over 100 minutes. So the number we will filter on is 100. We'll want to replace the placeholder with filter by duration. We don't need any initial value. And now let's go in preview mode and see what it looks like. So 100 minutes over 100 minutes over 10 over 50. So that corresponds to the labels that we set in our options. But if I click on a different label on a different option, this doesn't change. That's normal. What we need to do is back in editing mode on our collection list. So in this case, it's called a collection list, but it could be on any container. What's important is it's where we bound the items. So our items, let's go ahead and filter them. We can add a condition here, and what we will do is we will say the duration is more than X. We will bind it to our variable, so the 50, except the duration in our database was in seconds. And here, 50 is actually in minutes. So let's go ahead and multiply this by 60 so we get the seconds. And now we see that we only have the calls that are over 50 minutes. And why over 50 minutes? Because that's what is currently selected. That's the value that is currently selected. That's it. Now, if we go back to preview, let's see what happens if we do more than 100. Yes, it's all good. And more than 10, fine. We get that 19 again. That's it. That's how you filter a list of items in WeWeb using the select element.